And a good spiritual morning to you once again. First and foremost, Merry Christmas. Before I go into my normal introductions, I'm Father Cosmas. Thank you for joining me today for a quick video and a quick chat, sharing our morning cup of coffee on this beautiful Christmas day. And of course, I've got my Christmas sweater still going and the Christmas mug. And so I thought today I would just put out a very, very short, quick video. No one wants to watch a long video. It's Christmas. Today is a day where we're celebrating, where we're together, we're enjoying our friends and our family, celebrating with whomever we're able to be together with, considering some of the different restrictions that we're trying to follow and being safe. But I just really wanted to put out there a very simple message just to say, of course, Merry Christmas, a beautiful and happy and healthy new year as we're going into the new year. But today being a day of joy, and that we're celebrating this great joy together, and that we really try to remember that all day long. That's really what we're trying to focus on and keep, you know, in front of us, to remember that today is about celebrating the joy that we all feel when we're celebrating the incarnation, the birth of our Savior. Really, the way that we have, you know, salvation in Christ, it starts, you know, in a real tangible way with Him coming to earth, with His incarnation, with His being born in the flesh or according to the flesh. And so today is a day of joy. And we want to remember that and celebrate that, because there are going to be all sorts of little temptations that come to us today to try to take away that joy. And we have to fight against that. We have to fight against those temptations and enjoy the day. People tend to make accusations against Christians, and one of the main accusations is that they have no joy, that they're just, you know, always worrying about judgment and salvation, and there's all these rules, and they're just not happy. And that's really, of course, not true. We celebrate constantly. There's feast days throughout the year constantly where in the life of the church is saying, hey, celebrate. This is a day for joy, a day for us to be happy, and for us to enjoy feasting and having wonderful food. We're enjoying our family, we're enjoying company, and we're celebrating. So I would say, don't let, you know, the devil get in there and kind of pull you away from that joy. One of the best visuals to think about, and just to kind of remember, when you think about the icon of the Nativity, the icon of the birth of Christ, you think about that, it's kind of a mountain with a cave in the middle, and there's the Virgin Mary, and there's the Christ child, you know, laying in the manger. And up above are there angels and there shepherds, and there's some animals at the bottom. Usually at the far bottom corner somewhere, you see this man sitting, and you see this little old man kind of standing in front of him, kind of talking to him. And that's the temptation of Joseph. Joseph is the one sitting. He has the halo around him. And the little old man with the cane, that's the devil. And he's trying to tempt Joseph to take away his joy, to tempt him to say, there's no way that this could have happened like this. How could she have given birth and not known a man? How could there be an immaculate conception, an immaculate birth? He's trying to tempt him. And we have to make sure that we recognize the devil is always in there trying to stir up trouble, trying to tempt us. He's not this huge, scary monster. He's the spiraktira, this little thing that gets in there and just pits us against each other. You know, when you say the word devil in Greek, it's o diavolos, right? Diavolo literally means that I put one person against another person. And that's what the devil does, especially, most especially, on days like today, on holidays, where we're gathering together with friends, with family. Maybe you're not getting together. Maybe you're FaceTiming. Maybe you're on a Zoom call. Maybe you're on the phone. Whatever it is, there's going to be those temptations and those trials where the devil is trying to put one person against another. Don't give in to that. Remember, today is a day of joy, a day of happiness, where we're trying to celebrate the greatest gift, no matter what was under the tree. The greatest gift is the birth of our Lord and our Savior and the beginning of our salvation in Christ. Once again, may our newborn Christ bless us and keep us this day and every day. Amen.